Pat Love with Pat's 2 cents. Psalms 18, verses 25 through 28. With the merciful, thou wilt show thyself merciful. With an upright man, thou wilt show thyself upright. With the pure, thou wilt show thyself pure. And with the froward, thou wilt show thyself froward. For thou wilt save the afflicted people, but will bring down high looks. For thou wilt light my candle, the Lord my God will enlighten my darkness. Now, no matter what's going on in your darkness, you got to keep your spirit from all guile. You got to keep resentment, bitterness, anger, strife, wrath away from you. Because no matter what happens, no matter how it happens, if you keep your spirit pure, if you keep your spirit in a merciful state, sometimes you have to cut things away, but you're still keeping yourself in a merciful state and you're still walking in the ways of God and you're being as pure, truth, and honest as possible, truthful and honest as possible, you're taking responsibility for the part you played in your problem. Well, see, God will bless that. He will bless the merciful. He'll show himself merciful to you. He will show himself when you're living holy. He'll show himself straightforward and holy with you. When your heart is pure, he will be pure to you. But if you have a heart full of wrath, full of anger, full of spite, full of bitterness, full of backstabbing, full of wrath, what ends up happening is that's the way God will come back at you. So you always have to make sure that when you're in the point of your darkness, when you're in a dark period in your life, keep your heart clean. If you have to keep things out of your life in order to keep your heart clean. See, there are times that in family, sometimes family members can bring the worst out of you, right? And you know, some of you have even asked me, should I still go visit my mother? She's very abusive to me. And every time I get with her, I get caught up in all these negative emotions and I don't want to fall back into cussing and hatred and bitterness and all that. Well, sometimes you have to separate yourself from those you love in order to protect your own spirit from being filled with guile. Because you're still human. And some things you really can't handle. And if you can't handle it, stay away from it. That's the best thing to do. That way, if you keep your heart clean and pure, God will always keep life pure and clean and merciful for you. So that's how you protect yourself from falling back into your flesh. Never think you're above reproach. If you can't handle it, stay away from it. Just divorce yourself from it. Whatever you got to do to protect yourself. And God will continue to protect you. He will light your candle. He will enlighten your darkness. He will give you, that means he will also give you more understanding. He will help you understand yourself, your own failures, your own frailties, your own faults, your own fallacies. But he'll also teach you and help you understand other people so that you don't remain anger and bitter, but you'll be of an understanding heart. And with understanding, you can pray for them without having to succumb to their abuse or their abusive treatment of you. And if you're not in that abusive atmosphere, you keep your spirit clean. So you have to do whatever it takes to keep yourself in the light of God. Walk in his light. Don't walk in the darkness of other people. Don't walk in your own darkness and trust in the dark and all the threats that come from the dark. Trust in the light of God. He will teach you how to leap over a wall. He will make your way perfect ahead of you. He will bless you. He'll be a buckler to all those of you who trust in him. is our rock, you guys. He will gird us with strength and make our way perfect, even in the darkness. When we can't see it, He's got it under His control. He is in total control. But we have to relinquish control and sometimes just step out of it. Just step back and let God handle it. You hear me? Some of you need to let God fight your battles. You keep your mouth shut. Don't defend yourself. You let God fight your battles. Don't worry about what people think about you. Don't worry about what people say about you. Let God fight your battles. He'll vindicate you. He'll show who's who and what's what. Trust God. God bless you.